Coach's Corner with Don Cherry. Brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights. Buy yours now at Budweiser.ca.
Frank Selke in the hall with Jean Beliveau and Stafford Smythe for the official presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy.
Thank you, Ward, and I've got Davey Keon. And Davey, you're one of the kind of hockey players that Mr. Smythe is talking about. Just a great hockey player, a great competitor, and you've had a wonderful series.
Frank Selke, good guy, hockey night in Canada, one of the few that used to like me back in those days.
Hey, Don, you know one thing? His dad did the program in 1932 to raise money for the construction of Maple Leaf Gardens, and they thought they were going to produce 32,000. That would be plenty. They got 91,000 orders. It's like the Bud Light Red 10, Light.
10,000.
Yeah, and they got a million requests for the thing.
Him and Big Red, class couple. Now, you know, I got to say something about the Boston Bruins. The Boston Bruins in Canada, I think, are 23 wins, 2 losses. 18, I think, against 16 or something, they've won the Leafs. You know why? They're mostly Canadians. I'd like to say one more thing about the Boston Bruins, too. They have less power plays than anybody. You know why, Ron? I'll tell you why. They don't dive. It's always been that way since back then. If you dive, you're off the Boston Bruins. Consequently, they don't get many power plays. But you know why? Because they got most Canadians.
Brad Marchand, a little bit.
Well, Brad, that's okay. We put up with Lindsman, the rat. He's sort of like the rat himself. But we saw him a couple of years ago in the playoffs.
And Don Nazem Kadri, another big week for you.
You know, 6 points. And by the way, he's a good hockey. By reading the paper, and nobody would have ever thought. You know, I gotta say something. Something strange going on. He's 6 points, I think, in 2 games, leading the team, plus and minus, and the whole deal and everything. He gets on the second power play in Buffalo all the time. The other stiffs get on for a while, mash it up and everything. He gets on 43 seconds left. By the way, in the top 30 scorers in the National Hockey, he did pretty good in Buffalo last night. The top scorers in the National Hockey, they got that on each team. He plays less than anybody. Just thought I'd throw that in.
Of the respective teams, top scorer of the 30 teams, as opposed to the top 30 overall. I'm just making it clear. Okay, so
I don't make things clear?
Montreal Canadiens are missing Brandon Preston, you pointed out.
For all you dum-dums out there that think guys don't get hurt in icings, here's one of my favorite hockey players, leads the team right here, Brandon Preston. Look at this here. He's been out 2 weeks now. He leads the team. He's got 4 goals, their toughest guy, and he's best guy in plus and minus. He's been out 2 weeks. That icing will kill every team. But dum-dums think guys don't get hurt in that. But go ahead.
P.K. Subban.
You know, it's a funny thing, eh? How long ago did I say 2 years ago? You notice how he's playing now? Terrific. Minding his own business. That Bergeron and Therrien, they got him alone. They said, look, it's not you, it's the team. And he's playing now terrific. He could have caused
it, but it is interesting because he got the penalty against Buffalo Tuesday, and then he got benched against the Islanders.
Well, he shouldn't have ran there. He's just a kid. Sometimes you do that, you know. And he shouldn't have done it, but that's not the point. He wasn't doing it. That was okay. That was just a mistake. Ray's playing now. He's terrific. He's best young defenseman in the league right now. He could have caused a lot of heartache if he had to listen to me 2 years ago.
Dallas Stars and Jamie Benn.
Jamie Benn, BC boy. Now, you got to watch this, folks. We're going to show it fast. This is terrific. Jamie Benn got a 5-year contract, $25 million. Now, you don't see nothing now. But go to stop it. Watch the next one where his hands are. Watch this. Watch. Look at that. Hey, you kids should maybe practice that. Jamie Benn, one of the smartest guys. Good guy, too. Now, who else?
Andrew Cogliano. You know, can I say about Andrew that I noticed Getzlaff had less ice time than Cogliano. That's how much Boudreau thinks about him. In the game, that big game of the week against Chicago Blackhawks.
He's bounced around. He's always been, you know, a fast skater, can't score, can't do much. I saw him with the Vaughan Kings. He used to be able to score. Can't do much. But Boudreau's got him. He's plus, their highest plus. He's got 10 goals, and you can't stop him. The other night, and he's never missed a hockey game. Watch this here in the face-off. I can't blame the referees on this. This is a tough one like this. Got his teeth all knocked out. Watch now. He'll go over, and everybody figures he's done. I can't tell you what he said. All his teeth knocked out. He's done for this game. Oh, no, he's not. Never missed a shift. All right, Vaughan Kings, and boy, is he a nanny. Boudreau's got him going great.
Okay, visors.
Now, folks, somehow or other it's got that I don't like visors. Mm-hmm. I don't understand it. If you want to wear a visor and play it safe, play it safe. There's no problem. What bothers me is when guys put on a visor and they get tough. All of a sudden, they're going to take on the world. I don't mind if you want to play it safe. As Kirk Muller said, safety first. There's no problem. Mind your own business. But watch this here coming up. Here's Kalita, runs at a guy. Now watch the face-off. Here's a guy that wears a visor. This is what's coming, folks. Watch this here. Going to have a face-off coming up. Watch him yapping at Orr. He changes so Orr won't go out. He's got a big mouth now with a visor. Orr says, okay, now watch. He switches like that. He wants to get, hey, I don't want to get away from him, okay? Now watch what he does with the visor. Good guy McLaren wants to go. Scott, watch. Watch him turtle. Watch. Watch him go down. Watch him turtle now. He got a big mouth. Now he's got a big mouth. And look what happens. Look at him. Look at him. Orr got like, now look, these two guys have got a big yaps right now. I'm really surprised at Scott. I can understand the other. Remember, he wouldn't do anything. He turtled. Watch the two Toronto guys. They're just sitting there looking at him. What? Yeah, just look. They're just laughing at him. You don't see real tough guys do that. Now, if you want to wear a visor, no problem. Don't look for trouble. Don't pick on my tough guys and stuff like that. Just mind your own business. Nothing wrong with wearing a visor. Don't start acting tough.
And we're a little tight, as always, for time here, but this is nice.
Now, listen, folks. This is a goodie. I hope you like it. It's the Giants, Guelph Giants put this out. It's a special interest hockey. I met the little kid a long time ago. They don't know what this is happening. Now, wait a minute. They don't know this is happening. Watch Rico Aragon and my buddy that I've met a long time ago. Well, not a long time ago. Corey Stedman and the special interest. And this is great. Watch this.
You may not think that I can do this, but I can and I'm going to prove it. Win or lose, I'll see this through to the end. My family around to help me, and all my friends are ready and weary. Together we can all make a difference. Yes, I can.
Guy Jason Berry, he did a great job. Jason Berry, a thumbs up.
Coach's Corner on CBC, brought to you by Budweiser Red Lights. Buy yours now at budweiser.ca.